bet you will want to go over is just opening up that chair. Also working on our overall grip strength, and our with our shoulders, really for the most part, working on the internal rotation. So first things first, one of the most easiest things to do is if you were to come up against the wall, and let's say you have from your tailbone up to your shoulders, flat spine, so my entire spine from my shoulder to my tailbone is tucked against the wall. Taking my hand as much as I can, 90 degrees, touching the wall, again, keeping my spine from my shoulders to my tailbone, touching, and just trying to reach up without coming off of the wall, just to work on just overall scapula or shoulder length range of motion in a neutral position. Also, something else that we can do as well, you know, working on shoulders. So if we come here, we're at a 90 degree angle again, shoulder to tailbone, up against, it's flat against the wall, so my entire back is flat against the wall. And then one external rotation, coming out, touching the back of the wall, but what a lot of people have issues with or trouble with is internal rotation, keeping that elbow flat and coming all the way down as far as you can. Goal is really to come all the way down on the wall without the shoulder popping off or the elbow popping off. So doing that just a couple of times, just to work on that internal rotation, external shoulder rotation, really, really helpful, especially if you're sitting there and you're typing, driving, eating. sometimes we just kind of get locked in, so to say. So just working on just that overall range of motion. Something else you can do that's fun is you can also grab a stick. It can be a broomstick, mop stick. It can be whatever kind of stick you want it to be. And I say if you want to work on our overall wrist stretch. So if you look at our wrist, for the most part, when it comes to flexion or bringing it down towards our forearm, usually, most people are pretty good at that, but when it comes to external, coming out, that's where some people have issues. Some people have issues coming in as well, so just everyone's different on where their issue lies. So here's a fun and creative way. So if you have a broomstick, mop stick, or what I have, a dowel, very, very simple, just grab a dowel. You want palms facing you, so knuckles facing away. So I'm going to start with this hand, so I'm going to bring the stick down to where the end is about right here. Both hands are right around shoulder height. Then I'm going to make sure I'm holding one with both hands, trying to keep the stick shoulder height, and I'm going to rotate in. So I have some shoulder internal rotation, but I'm also working on my wrist stretch as well. My wrist is getting stretched as well. And I can also push out as well, bring it back in, so got a little flexion, extension, do that one more time, so here, boom, the goal is trying to do it without moving the upper body, really just be the wrist moving. As you can see, I have things I have to work on, so we do the obviously do the other wrist, same thing, and know each wrist is going to be different. They work independently of each other. One more time. Alright. That's just a fun way of working on wrist extension, flexion. Also, we went over overall shoulder internal, external rotation. And we also went over this overall shoulder blade scapula mobility. So that's your active work break for now. Hope you have a great day.